Hello and welcome to the Rotterdam Update, a cooperation between OGAE and ESC Daily, in which we will give you 15 minutes of news about this year's Eurovision Song Contest. We're here in front of Ahoy, where the Eurovision Song Contest of 2021 will finally take place.
Hello, my friends.
And here we are in Ahoy, in the press center of the Eurovision Song Contest. And when you're inside, you are required to wear a mask, except for when you are presenting as a journalist. Then when you're on camera, you can take it off. The same goes for the artists. They have to wear a mask when they're moving through the building, but on stage, they can take it off. As you can see, there are still a lot of requirements taken to keep COVID out of Ahoy. And this is important, of course, because we want to keep this Eurovision Song Contest as corona-free as possible. However, it's still possible that at a certain point, an artist will get sick or will get infected and cannot perform during the live TV shows. What would happen then? Well, of course, all these countries took a backup tape. They shot it back at home in their own TV studios to make sure that no matter what would happen, there would always be a Eurovision Song Contest. We now spoke to Twan van den Nieuwenhuizen. He's the head of contest this year, and he accompanied this entire process of the backup tapes.
We came up with this plan of, as an extra obligation for each delegation to create this backup video, so no matter what happens, if a delegation was not allowed to travel to the Netherlands because of travel restrictions, or if they are in Rotterdam, maybe also had a rehearsal, but then someone of the delegation, maybe the artist or someone else, will get infected, will get sick, then we still can continue the show. We still have a backup video we can use.
Perfect. Good luck to you.
Okay, thank you very much.
They made their backup video in a TV studio in their own country, but we were there. We were via a Teams connection there with someone from EBU, someone from Ernst & Young, and Emily, my colleague Emily and I, just to watch if the process was, well, according to the rules, of course. Vocally, the singer, the artist, has to perform live. And within a set time frame of 1 hour, 60 minutes, they could do their act three times. And then after it, within that same hour, they have to decide which one they preferred. And we also had to see on our server that the full mix of the act they choose was started uploading in the full mix.
We will choose now, we will select, okay? We will ask singer as well to listen. And we will start uploading.
Yes, perfect. So there's no chance that they can tweak a bit or change maybe some audio file, maybe the voice of the singer was not that great. So it was completely honest.
We selected the third one. We think that this was the best one.
We trust you on that, the third one. We know for sure at this moment that Australia is the only one will compete with their backup video. I do deeply hope they will be the only one.
Thank you very much.
Good luck, and we see each other in Rotterdam, and of course you can close the call. So good luck to you. Bye-bye.
Good luck to you as well. Bye-bye.
Montaigne from Australia will definitely be using her backup tape, and let's hope that, as Twan van den Nieuwenhuizen said, she will be the only one and that the other artists can all perform live here on stage. The item that you just saw was made by Team ESC Daily in cooperation with host broadcaster NPO. And this news update is a cooperation between ESC Daily and OGAE International. Now, OGAE is the fan club for the Eurovision Song Contest. So we now have for you some content, exclusive content, made by fans. An interview with former Eurovision winner Gertie Kaspers.
It took 44 years before the Netherlands won Eurovision again. All this time, Tietjen was the Dutch record holder with a song we still sing along. Hi Gertie, how are you?
I'm fine. I'm very fine.
Yeah. Hey, when Duncan won, were you relieved or a little bit disappointed that you were not the last winner anymore?
I was not disappointed. It took a long, long time that Netherlands had to win. So, for me it was okay. And Duncan had a very nice song, so why not?
Yeah, you won the contest in 1975 with Tietjen. How did you experience the week in Stockholm during your participation?
Yeah, it was very busy and we had a lot of rehearsals every day. But we had to start the song contest, so we always had to... the rehearsals has been very early in the morning. And... But after all, it was a very, very nice time there. Special time, once in a lifetime. So, I think it was a very, very fine week.
And what is it? What is it the most important that Eurovision brought you?
The Eurovision brought me, after all these years, still, I'm famous, so... And every time, every year, they come to visit me or for interviews, so I'm not forgotten.
You still enjoy all the attention?
Of course, it's nice.
And with what you know now, what would you have done differently?
I think you cannot say that because it's many, many years ago and everything was different in that time. So I think... it's okay like it was, and I'm still very happy that we won. So I don't want to change something.
No. Yeah. And you won in 1975. Did that mean that ABBA handed over the trophy that year? Did you meet them?
It's a pity we didn't.
Oh, you didn't?
Because I heard that they had holidays, and another one says they were not invited. They were not invited there, so we don't know. But it was a pity.
I can imagine. Yeah. And you are now being remembered for Eurovision. If that wasn't the case, what would you prefer to be remembered for?
As a good human being, a very normal good human being. I think that's the most important thing in life. And to accept every person like he is. And so I think that's the most important thing, and I love people.
Yeah, you're not really into fame and everything? And
No. I haven't been... I always have been a normal girl next door.
And are you involved in the final this year? Are you going to do something?
Yes, we do something. We are invited to do a medley with other artists, day one. So it will be a very nice time. I think that we are there, it's okay. And we sing a little bit ding-a-dong.
Ah, okay, that's nice. So you're looking forward to that?
Of course. Of course.
Okay, and well, it's... part of a Corona field lab experiment, mm-hmm. the whole Eurovision this year in Holland. People over 70 are not invited.
Mm-hmm.
That also means all the old contestants,
yes.
Lenny Kuhr, Willeke Alberti, you are not welcome to join the grand final. So you have to watch it from home.
I will do that because it's the best thing to stay in home. And with a glass of wine and something we like very, very much, you know. So we stay in home and take a look. But after all, it's a pity because of this stupid COVID. So we cannot do something. We cannot go in and we cannot be there. So, okay. It's like that.
Yeah, well, maybe the host of next year, that country will invite you.
We hope that.
Thank you so much. It was nice talking to you. And I wish you a pleasant time on Saturday evening. Enjoy the show.
Thank you. And all of you too.
Getty Kasper, she was of course the lead singer of Teach In, the band that won the Eurovision Song Contest. And as the contest is nowadays, we see that these lead singers always get a lot of media attention. Journalists want to go to their press conferences and they want to interview them one-on-one. That happens here in the interview area, where there are special rooms for these artists to join with one other journalist on social distance, on 1.5 meter distance, to give their interviews. But it's not only about these lead singers, of course. There are people in the background, backing vocalists or dancers, who give just as much an important contribution to these performances as the lead singers. We decided that every day from now on, we will put one of those background people in the spotlight.
Hi, my name is Reno Andersen.
My name is Eivind, and we are both dancers for Norway.
I can't make her stay. When I know that she's so far above.
So I knew that we were going to have the wings on. I knew we were going to do a lot of squats, you know, the demon movement, or whatever we're going to call it. I put on a backpack with a lot of weights. I was really, really tired the first times. But, you know, then you get better, better, and better.
No.
The wings makes the movements a bit more difficult because there's like a square plate on your back. So like everything you could do like without the wings, you can't do anymore.
And then we have the chains.
Yeah.
So another element just to make it a little bit more difficult.
That's where angels belong.
I think it would be a really different kind of number if you could see our faces. Mm. Because then you can start like putting a character on the person instead of it being... We're supposed to be like entities that aren't like human. But yeah, I've also taught the thought like, oh,
yeah.
They don't see me now. I'm like, I'm the demon on the right side of
yeah.
the TV. Like,
now
hello.
On the left side. There's always a hope of winning,
yeah.
Obviously. But also it's nice, you know, for Tix, he's such a great guy to work with.
So he has had such a good year in Norway with like, with people, with actually talking about mental health and stuff. It makes me really want him to win, not in the sense only for like for Norway to win, but for him as like an underdog.
Reach up to heaven, to you.
The Eurovision post-it wall this year is a special feature that we use to give a shout out to anyone who cannot be here this year, of course, because there's a lot of people that we wish could be here but who are not. You just saw the item about the Norwegian backing demons, basically, or black angels as they call them themselves. And if you're a fan of the Norwegian entry this year, then you're in luck, because later this week we will have a very special item about their use of props. For right now, we're going into the last item of this news update, which is a daily recurring item made by our partners from the website Eurostory. They are a literary Eurovision website about the Eurovision Song Contest, in which they take a closer look at the lyrics of every Eurovision song. And every year they have an award, the Eurostory Award, for the best lyrics of this year's contest. There are 5 nominees, and every day they will introduce one of them.
We are Eurostory. For the 5th time this year, we present the Eurostory Best Lyrics Award for the best lyrics of the Eurovision song of this year. The first nominee is Bulgaria. Victoria said this song is a message from Victoria to Victoria. And the jury says this is a coming-of-age story in 3 minutes. And it all starts off with a wonderful metaphor, playing Tetris with my feelings. And the song ends with a beautiful and touching last line. So this is our first nominee.
We saw Bulgaria was nominated for the Eurostory Award because of the beautiful lyrics of their song. And there are four more nominees, which you will find out one by one every day from now on in this Eurovision news update. We are at the end of today's update, but not before I tell you that I want you to be a part of this update as well. Because the Eurovision Song Contest this year is a strange one, and not a lot of people are coming to Ahoy, not as much as we would hope to come here to Ahoy. And because of that, more and more people are celebrating Eurovision on remote, from home this year. If you are one of those people, if you are watching the Eurovision show in your living room, and you decorated it with flags and with all kinds of other Eurovision memorabilia, just to create that perfect Eurovision atmosphere, please give us a call, send us a short clip of you in your living room preparing for those Eurovision live shows, and maybe you will end up in this news update tomorrow.